And welcome to another week of InCourage. We are super excited to see what God's got in store for us. Let's just open up in prayer. Father God, we thank you for a lovely week that we had, Father God. Whether it was tough, whether it was fun, Lord Jesus, thank you that we made it through, Lord God. And thank you that you are with us every step of the way. Father, we pray that you would be with us with the service today, Father God, that you would be in every part of the service, Lord God. You are welcome, and we ask you to come and sit amongst us today. In your beautiful name, amen. So I have the privilege of sharing the message on Mother's Day. Isn't that awesome? Dewald makes mothers work on Mother's Day. Thanks, Dewald. No, just kidding. I am very honored to share with you guys today. I was very nervous, but the Lord has been so faithful in sharing his heart with me this week, and I want to share that with you. So in the light of Mother's Day, we are obviously celebrating these amazing people in our lives, and I was just thinking about my mom. Guys, I seriously hit the jackpot when it comes to mothers. My mom is honestly a super mom. And so when we were young, she was at every netball match, at every swimming gala, she was at every table tennis match, she was picking us up, driving us wherever we needed to be. When we got home, it was literally the food is cooked, the house is clean, if I need any kind of clothes, change of clothes, I had it. Ironed, washed, smelling good. And so I was spoiled with the idea that that is what a mom is to everybody. And I obviously noticed along the way, like as growing up, that not all my friends have the same kind of mom and same things and attributes in a mom as I did. And so when I became a mom, did I realize how tough that, how the expectation was, yeah guys, how tough it was to actually keep up with the idea that I had of a mom. I definitely don't have the natural ability of my mom to want to clean the house, to want to do the dishes, to want to do the washing. My mom loves that, and that's her, she thrives on that. For me, it was a challenge, and it still is, and I don't enjoy it at all. I do it because I have to, or if somebody's coming to my house. That's pretty much when I do it. And it is a challenge for me. So when I was failing at that super mom vibe, I always felt guilty. I always felt that I wasn't good enough, or I just keep trying, but it's not great. But that's because my expectations of a mom were so, so, so high because of my mom. And thinking about other moms, and even in my family, moms of my family, as well as moms of my friends, I realized that there is a vast spectrum type of moms. And I was just lucky to get the super mom. And for me, it was, if we are made in the image of God, we are, right? We're made in the image of God. Why doesn't everybody get a super mom? Because if we're made in the image of God, surely we should all have a super mom. But we are different. And so in Genesis 1 verses 26, it says, we are made in the image of God. Both man and woman are made in the image of God. And so then I was thinking, oh golly, if we're made in the image of God, God is both mother, he has motherly attributes, as well as fatherly attributes towards us. And is that possible? Is it possible for God to have motherly attributes as well as fatherly attributes? Is it possible for God to be both lion and lamb? And it is. Our God is a God of the impossible. And he is that. Let's look at the characteristics of a lion. A lion is powerful, and a lion has authority. And God is referring to himself as the Lion of Judah. So the Lion of Judah is powerful and has authority. Yet he's also the Lamb of God. Jesus is referred to as the Lamb of God, which is gentle and approachable. And is God not that to us? Is he not powerful and showing authority as well as being gentle and approachable? He is. And so if we are literally made in the image of God, God has literally taken a copy and paste. He copied the image of God, is copied and put into Adam, and the image of God, we made in the image of God, copy and paste to Eve. And so whatever God is, we should have access to. And it was very exciting to me to think, for me to think this week, that if God is both, he didn't say, I'm going to copy these little bits of me and put it in Adam, and I'm going to copy these little bits and put it in Eve. He literally copy and pasted. That means I have full access to his power, his authority. We have full access to his approachability and his gentleness. And so we also, inside of us, whether you're a male or a female, we have got motherly attributes and fatherly attributes, and we need to learn to access that. And so let's look in scripture at some very physical attributes, where they tie physical attributes to God and a mother, motherly attributes. And so in Numbers 11 verses 12, it says Moses reminds God. Now this is when Moses has taken the Israelites out of Egypt and he's in the wilderness, and obviously everything is not going perfect because people are people and we start complaining. And so they're moaning and bickering and all this stuff is happening, and Moses is like, whoa, this is hectic. God, I need to remind you that you are the mother of these people that I'm leading. You are the one that conceived them, you gave birth to them, and you carried them and nursed them. It's your people. So there he's referring to God as the motherly type. In John 3 verses 3 to 8, Jesus says, no one can be saved unless they're born again, both of water and of the Spirit, because flesh gives birth to flesh and the Spirit gives birth to the Spirit. Peter 2 verses 2 to 3 says, like newborn babies, crave, guys, he's saying, crave spiritual milk so that you may grow up in salvation. And so those are just physical attributes, linking and tying that to God. Now, if you look at yourself and you think, just take a moment and consider in your life, in your marriage, in your actions, in your morals, in even your giftings, can you somehow see somewhere that you might have these motherly attributes? In my house, I am the disciplinarian, not necessarily Jake's, actually not at all Jake's. I am the one that when the fire needs to come, the fire comes through me. And so if you had to ask Jess who she's scared of, she tells me all the time, it's you, Mom. I'm not scared of Dad. I'm scared of you. And that's because I discipline her. Does that make me more manly than Jake's? No. Does it make Jake's more feminine because he's not the disciplinarian? No, not at all. So I am not talking about feminine qualities, but rather motherly attributes. I have a clip that I'm going to be showing you guys, and just have a look, and we'll chat about it afterwards.
Oh,
All right, so here we have the classic story of Nemo. Nemo's dad happened to find himself in the position of being a single dad. And he had to now plug those gaps where the moms would have been and filling those little roles. He had to now adjust himself. Yes, it is a cartoon, but it is so applicable to our lives. He had to now do the caring part. He had to do the watching out and wondering where he is and if he is okay. And did that make him any more feminine? No. But it just showed that he has the ability to have that access to the motherly qualities, and he just needed to access them. All right. Copy and paste, guys. We're being a copy and paste of God. That means we've got it. We just got to access it. All right. So now let's look at five motherly attributes of God. I've chosen five because I'm sure that there are thousands, because mothers fill the gaps in every way. So number one, security. Okay, guys, I am old school. I like handwritten notes, and I like shuffling through the Bible. So if you are with me, grab your Bible, and let's read it together. All right, so the first one is security. And that is in Proverbs 3, verses 26. Okay, Proverbs 3, verses 26. And here it says, "For the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being snared." Now God himself is showing us that he will be our security. And a mother, that's what she does. She makes sure that her little chickens are all safe. And feeling safe around your mom is definitely, and I'm hoping that most of us have had the privilege of feeling that security. And for God to be saying, "For the Lord will be your confidence." Your confidence, guys. If you don't have confidence, we are always going to be scared. But God is our confidence. And that's just awesome. And then in Isaiah 41, verses 13. Let's go there. "For I am the Lord your God, who takes hold of your right hand and says to you, 'Do not fear, I will help you.'" And that is just awesome. Isn't that awesome, guys? That he gives us that safe place, that security. And if there is anyone who can make us feel safe and secure, it's God. Now, this week, I had one of those melt-your-heart moments with Jess. Obviously, load shedding, we all know what that is. And we had that in the 6 o'clock slot, the worst slot, I feel. That's the worst slot. We had the 6 o'clock slot. Lights go off, and it is pitch dark. And she gets that, even though that there's candles around and there is light, she always feels that she is not okay to be in the room by herself. And so she's like, "Mom, will you come with me to the toilet? Will you come with me to the room and to the kitchen?" And once we had done all her little errands, we came and sat on the couch, and she just looked at me and she said, "You know what? I feel safe when you're with me." Oh, melt your heart. It was such a privilege that is who we are. As mothers, and our motherly qualities can make somebody feel safe and secure. Right, number two is healing. Mothers, with their plasters, with our hearts, they definitely show us the healing qualities. And let's see it in God. In Matthew 15, 28. So let's turn there to Matthew 15, 28. And it says, "Then Jesus answered, 'Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted, and your daughter was healed from that very hour.'" Now, this was a lady who was from considered a Canaanite, which is the enemy of the Israelites. And she had a daughter that was demon-possessed, and she heard that Jesus was around, and she went to Jesus, and she was persistent. And she was not going to leave there until Jesus had healed her daughter. And so even though she knew that she was seen as the enemy and that not the favored kind of people, she was insistent that God, that Jesus would heal her. And because of that, because of her faith, Jesus had said, "All right, you can go. Your daughter is healed." How amazing is that? God is our healer. All right, next one is in Matthew 8, verses 7. And it says, Jesus said to him, I will go and heal him. Now this is a story about a centurion. He was a very powerful man, and he also showed the faith that God wants to see in us. Healing, and that often comes with that faith. They like hand in hand. And so he came up to Jesus and he said to Jesus, Jesus, there is my servant. I'm a very powerful man, but my servant is at home. He's paralyzed. Please, I would love you to heal him, please. And then Jesus said, Jesus, I'm not even worthy for you to come under my roof. So don't even do that. Just speak. And I know that your words will heal him. And Jesus actually turned around to the people and said, I haven't seen faith like that. And so Jesus healed his servant. Jesus is our healer, guys. It's awesome. All right, the third step is sacrifice. And sacrifice, we know that mothers are that. They will sacrifice their very selves to cater for the children. And let's see that in scripture. So sacrifice, John 3:16. There is no greater sacrifice, right? John 3:16, let's go there and turn there. We all know the scripture well. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. God gave his only son. The biggest sacrifice that we could ever have asked for. That whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Sure. Number four, training. Let's turn to Timothy, 2 Timothy. We're going to turn to 2 Timothy, 3 verses 16 and 17. All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. All scripture is God-breathed, guys. He never left us. He didn't. He would never. He left us with the biggest and best training manual. Whenever you go in anywhere, when you go to a new job, when you buy a new TV, what do we get? We get an instruction manual. He gave us the instruction manual that the VIPs get. This thing, the Bible, the Word of God, is all we need to live a good life and a life worthy of God. All right. So now the last one is number four, and that is faith. Faith. We're going to turn to Hebrews. Hebrews 11, verses 1. Now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. Faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we do not see. Now, is it not true that our mothers have the most faith in us? And I'm sure that American Idols can definitely attest to that. That, my baby, you can sing. You go and sing. And off they go and they sing. Your mom is your biggest supporter. But God, guys, think of this. God has the most faith, even above your mom's, the most faith in you than anyone else. He is literally sitting, Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father, interceding for you, rooting for you, saying, go, my boy. He sees the potential that is in you. He sees what he's created you to be. He never looks at your stumblings. He never looks at your downfalls. He never looks at when you fail at something. He is literally rooting for you. He's saying, go, my boy. You've got this. You've got the things. Access what I've given you and go, go, go. He is our biggest supporter, our biggest fan. If only we could see ourselves through our mother's eyes, right? But imagine seeing yourself through God's eyes. Imagine how much God is seeing in you the potential, the gifting, the possibilities of who you can be, your identity. He knows who he's made you to be. And can you imagine seeing yourself through those eyes? That would be awesome. It's like a mother hen, you know, like she will attack anything, whether it's 10 times bigger than her, she will go at it if it's going to go for her chicks. To protect her little chicks, she will run after a fox or anything 10 times bigger than her. All right. We want to be like Christ, right? We want to be like him. So take what he's given us and use it to bless others, guys. Take those motherly and channel those motherly attributes and let's help each other. So let's see how we can maybe apply this or recognize these attributes in our lives. All right, let me put my Bible down. All right, number one, security, right? Think about your life and think about, is there anyone, someone maybe in your workplace, maybe at home or in church or in your family who needs some kind of security? I'm not talking about trailer door. I'm talking about a sense of security, a safe place, a safe friend who they can come to and maybe just dump everything onto and just feel better. Because you know when you are burdened with something and you actually get the chance to go and chat to your mom, it is awesome. You feel lighter. You feel like, sure, nothing really was solved, but you do feel better. And so is there somebody that you can be that person to? Number two, healing. Guys, we live in a broken world, and I think COVID seriously opened our eyes to mental health issues and mental health problems and people that we never thought were going through anything, and anxiety, depression are huge, and we saw that with COVID. Is there somebody around you that you could maybe give a testimony to on how you overcame something? Is there somebody that you can maybe just listen to or advise on some situation? Those kind of things can really, really impact somebody's life just by showing that you're there, and also by showing that you also have weaknesses. We're not strong. All of us, we are not always strong. But when you are strong, be that helper to the others that are not strong. Maybe you can drive their children or babysit their children while they go and see somebody or something like that. God will stir it up in your hearts when and the timing for these situations. But just be aware and open-minded to maybe somebody around you that are showing these kind of signs that maybe they just need a little bit of support. Number three, guys, sacrifice. Now, God showed us that he sacrificed the biggest thing. What is the biggest thing in your life to sacrifice? Is it time? Is it money? Is it commitment? Sacrificing something as big as your time because we have so little will show somebody that you are there, that you're caring for them. And we're living for others, guys. What are we here for? What is kingdom? Kingdom is not for ourselves. So yes, it's great for you to have a family and spend as much time with them as possible and have absolutely no time for somebody else. No, God wants us to live for others. He wants us to, those extra moments where you've got time to maybe go for a coffee with somebody, that's a sacrifice because we don't have much of that. But God expects us to fill those gaps, fill up those times with people so that we can impact the outside world. Outside world, that sounds very, very weird, eh? Sorry, that is not what I meant. I meant people outside of us. That's what I meant. Outside of our homes, God wants us to impact them. All right, let's get back onto track. Number four, training. All right. Is there someone that can learn from you? Guys, we have so much to give. We have so much. You might not think it, but we do. We have lots to give. You may know how to bake really well. You may know how to do handyman work. Is there somebody that will benefit from you? And I think, and I know Jakes and I shared this not so long ago, where he learned so much from my dad, and not having a dad growing up, he didn't know the small things like how to drill and hammer and unplug drains and everything like that. And my dad taking the time and sacrificing that time for him and training him has literally given him the foundation that he could build upon. And it's been detrimental to us. It's been amazing that, like, life goes on, and those little gems that we acquire along the way is amazing. So is there something small that you guys can give to somebody around you? And then faith, guys. Again, mothers have the biggest faith in us. Thank goodness for mothers. But your testimony is power. Do you know that your testimony in situations that you have overcome can develop and grow somebody's faith? Just hearing that you have gone through a season and you've come out on the other side can be amazing for somebody else who's going through that season and that detriment, like that dense, that heavy season. They can see that there is hope because you've done that. You've gone through that. Just this week, I was chatting to a very young girl, and she's not married yet, but hoping very soon. And she was sharing with me that she suffers with PCOS, which PCOS is polycystic ovarian syndrome. And that just complicated means a whole lot of cysts growing inside of your ovaries, and it makes it almost impossible for you to have children, and it throws your hormones out of whack. It literally, all those cysts are giving off testosterone, and so it literally flips all the things that a woman is inside and needing to be a mom. It flips it over, and it's like all this testosterone is coming out. And she was down. She said, you know, like, she's going to the doctors, she's going to go and see specialists to see what she can do now while she's not married to prepare for the years to come. And I just said to her, you know that I've got PCOS. And she went, what? And you've got a child, right? And then she got all excited. And then I got a bit of time to share with her my journey coming into motherhood. And also stories from other people that have journeyed along the same journey that I know of and have 4 children. And so she was so excited to say, like, sure, so there is hope that I can see maybe there are options for me. And so just sharing your testimony, don't underestimate the power your testimony can be in somebody's life. Again, guys, I want to encourage you to look at your life. Look where you can give somebody some kind of motherly attribute, some kind of motherly encouragement. I want you to be aware, and even if you can't identify that now and those people now, just be aware of it. Let it be on your radar so that when those situations do come, that you will be able to see, oh, this is exactly where I can bless them. And so I'm going to close on John 13, verses 35, and it says, and by these all men will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. Guys, we are here to make a difference in others' lives. We are not here to grow ourselves and become big and heavy in the spirit. We are here to give and give and give and give. And so make yourself available for God to use you in motherly kind of attributes. Let's close our eyes. Father God, we thank you. We thank you that we have been a copy and a paste of you, Father God. We have access to motherly qualities, even if we are a male, even if we are a female, and that it doesn't come naturally to us. Thank you that you are the lion and the lamb. Thank you that you are both mother and father to us. And that in our lives, when we need that motherly attributes, when we need that motherly warmth, Father God, we can come to you because you are fully, fully mother and father to us. Thank you that we lack nothing in you, Father God. And we pray that you would make us more available, make us more aware of the people around us. What, may we not be so busy and occupied with the things of God, but let us now be aware and activated in our spirit to the needs of others around us. Help us, Father, to know you more so that we may make you known to others. Help us to see those needs in others. Give our spirits the wisdom to discern when and where you are needed. Help us to be bold and share our testimonies to others as much as we can. And help us to be relevant, Father God. Help us not to use things that happened donkeys years ago, but help us to be so in tune with your spirit that our testimonies are fresh. We can be an encouragement to somebody right now because it happened to us not so long ago. May our revelation of you be continually changing. May you be the focus of our everyday. May we pray, Lord Jesus, in the mornings and say, who is it that you want us to share with today? Who is it that you want us to nurture? Who is it that you want us to support and give security in a safe space? Father God, I pray that you would just help us to be more aware of the things around us and not of our world. Help us not be distracted. And help us, Lord God, to be outwardly focused so that your name can just go into all the corners of the earth. Thank you, Father God, for seeing us worthy. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you alone are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And thank you that you have given us this access to all of your giftings and your storeroom of goodies for us. May we tap into that and draw near to you as we do that. Thank you, Lord Jesus, in your wonderful name. Amen. Now, I really hope, guys, that you go and you bless your moms this Mother's Day, that you see that mom that was given to you as a gift, and that you would just bless her over and over for all the kind of mom on that spectrum, whether she's a super mom, whether she's a medium mom, whether she is a growing mom. Each one of them were given to you as a gift. And I pray that you would to take the message that the Lord laid on my heart and tap into that God has given you free access to. It is a storeroom full of goodies. And may you enjoy your Mother's Day.
Wow, Rochele, that was an absolutely amazing word. It's so awesome to look at things from a completely different perspective. The motherly attributes of God. That is absolutely amazing. And guys, I hope you celebrated your mothers today. I hope you're celebrating your mothers today. And to all the moms out there, we love you so much. And thank you for being who you are. That's us for today. It was a fantastic service. And if you want to connect with us on our social media platforms. The handles are all there. If you feel like you want to contribute and give to this ministry, please feel free to do so. And thank you, guys. Let's go forth and have a fantastic week. Awesome.